worried by the lack of social amenities in some riverine communities in Lagos and the resultant health challenges faced by inhabitants. Many of them are now calling for government's quick intervention. A visit to Tarkwa-bay community, for instance, revealed that for many years, there has never been a flash of light from an electric power source, and health facilities in the area grossly inadequate. Residents of the community told AIT that they only see and feel government presence every 4 years when politicians come to canvass for votes during elections.
Sitting on this island in a Tiosa council area of Lagos is Tarkwa-bay community, giving habitation to about 150,000 dwellers who are predominantly fishermen, petty traders, and boat drivers. Tarkwa-bay community is faced with a plethora of challenges, one of which is inadequate health facilities. Though the only primary health care center within the community has been given a facelift by the state government, the available doctors and nurses are grossly inadequate.
They don't get doctor, they don't get nurse, that kind. Everybody need a good day. If everything get program, they will rush them, go Lagos. Some woman, the enemy go die, they no go see baby.
When I come back this 2 days, now this fever can worry me. Yeah, sometimes if I go for the hospital, they before you go see doctor self, now wahala.
God has been, you know, coming to our help. At times, if anyone wants to get out of hand, we cross them to Nasutu Lagos.
Sheon Olabode, a mother of four, had a harrowing experience delivering her set of twins.
The day I was born, it was small. That day, early morning and Saturday, I was feeling pain. So I wake my neighbor, say, please, oh, bless, I want to give birth. My neighbor now follow me to that nurse. The nurse is staying at my side. She now say, my time is reached to born. So I was looking time. Around 7, she said, you be doing exercise. Go and come. So she now carry me enter. And I can eat. So I enter, she now tell me that, okay, I should sleep. She will do it for me. She now start praying. And I give birth to this girl. So she now tell me she's menu. I said, no, nothing is my body again. She said, one is inside. I said, no. She said, she's seeing one leg again. I said, no, it's a lie. Because I'm not feeling anything. The outside body is fine. She now said, she's seeing one leg. Look at the leg. See the mark. It's only this leg. So she not try to look. She says she's in one leg. I said, no, nothing is inside my body. So we are there. She's not calling my husband. My husband is not staying with me anymore. She's went away with another woman. So I'm starting bleeding. Bleeding, very bleeding. So we have chair. The one big small chair like this. So then I used to carry me. I can't walk anymore. Girl. I've tried a lot, but I can't. So they now rush me to jetty. They now take me to boat. Take me to Badri, Ajegunle. The doctor now told me that they will do DS for me. So they will do operation for me. I said no. So I have not done it before. So I thank God, sir. The doctor came back. She now said they will not do the operation again. So that is why we now, I now give birth to the boy. I now born the boy.
Like Sheon. Many women in Tarkwa-bay community have horrifying tales of their childbirth. Managing waste in Tarkwa-bay community also poses a big challenge. Here, there are no toilet facilities, and so open defecation is commonplace.
This is yet another spot where refuse is dumped, and you've got several other spots like this scattered within the community. And what the residents told me is that what they do is at the end of the day, they simply dig the ground to bury the waste, or they simply burn them. And this has great environmental implications.
We don't have toilets. No toilets. Even small pikin, na nylon we dey use. Hey, that's disease. We used to swim inside the water. We used to swim inside the water. And two, there's no dustbin in this community. We used to dig sand and bury it. And we used to vote.
That's not all. The community has no electricity supply, a situation which has crippled businesses here. Worried by this, health and development experts are asking government to pay attention to Tarkwa-bay community to prevent unnecessary loss of lives.
What happens to that woman that wants to give birth in the middle of the night? Children that develop some emergency care and want to access health services in the middle of the night. That means they are on their own. They don't have power. As we've walked around, we've not seen one pole that powers electrical stuff in this community.
To the experts, if Nigeria must achieve the Sustainable Development Goals target, then government must begin to prioritize public resources towards delivering quality healthcare services and provision of social amenities to vulnerable communities like Tarkwa-bay in the country. Nkoli Omoju, AIT News, Lagos.